and a shield versus the Miz and the Bar, Sheamus and Cesaro. Of course, AJ and the Shield pick up the win. From there, we had matchup after matchup, including one of the best of the best going at it in the Demon King, Finn Balor versus the Big Red Monster, the Big Red Machine, that Devil's favorite demon. But not only that, Asuka made her Raw debut in a TLC rematch against Emma. And of course, Asuka picks up the win. We had Sasha Banks, Bayley, and Alicia Fox go ahead in a triple threat. Alicia Fox won that one. We had Elias Sampson versus Jason Jordan. Jason Jordan won that one due to disqualification. And then we had none other than the Cruiserweights in action. Enzo Amore, Drew Gulak, Noam Dar, Daivari, and because I don't care about those guys, period. Versus none other than Cedric Alexander, Rich Swann, Grand Metal Lake, Mustafa Ali, and of course, Kalisto. And as they called themselves Team Lucha Lucha, Kalisto's team won the match. But then, the Beast Incarnate came out talking. And he accepts the challenge of Jinder Mahal. But then, unbelievably, Shane O'Mac actually had planned out an attack on Monday Night Raw. Kurt Angle was in the ring, about to talk about the men's Survivor Series team. But that had an unfortunate detour when Shane O'Mac came out. SmackDown's roster surrounded the ring, and Kurt Angle heard one simple phrase before running for the hills. Hashtag under siege. Then Shane O'Mac turned the wolves loose. Unbelievable show. Arguably one of the best in a long time. Can't wait to see how Raw responds to SmackDown's attack. 'Cause no doubt, Raw is not gonna take this lying down. We'll have to see what comes tomorrow on Super SmackDown Tuesdays. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like the videos, give them thumbs up. And I'll see you guys in the next round. Welcome to the black hole of eternal damnation. And as my alter ego would say,
adios, mi amigos.